Bill Evans, but that's not the punchline. The punchline was his quote, where he said that once I realized that all I had to do was focus on the music, remember this quote, everything else took care of itself. Now, that wasn't exactly true in Bill Evans' own life, but focusing on the music is what he got into. And lest you think that I'm walking around with my shoes on in blatant non-observation of Tom's request, I can't run the pedals on the keyboard without my shoes, so I have cleaned my shoes impeccably to allow myself to be able to use my shoes while I play.
I have one question. If everybody can be quiet for 1 second, I want to hear, I can hear a click. Listen.
It's a metronome.
I know, but where is that coming from? Because it's being picked up by the microphones, and that's my problem, is that I have to be able to have this as a clean track without, Gordon's here.
It's in the headphones.
Fine. I guess what we need to do is when everybody puts on their headphones, I need to see if I can hear the click, and if so, where it is. So
put on the headphones. You can hear one from mine.
I know, but what I'm saying is when you put them on, I should be able to hear it.
So everybody put them on?
Yeah, well, everybody put on their headphones. See, that was my problem is I can hear this click. Hi, Gordon.
Hey.
You're there. Middle. Okay, quiet for a second. All I hear is a dog. Great. Okay, good. Then it's just the headphones people to have.
Okay. One other comment, particularly for brass players. Question, Randy?
Quick bathroom break.
Okay, actually, hang around for this. David, are you there?
Yeah.
So I want you to conscientiously not play louder than you need to. Okay.
So we
play loud enough. But the reason you're all wired up, obviously, is that in the mixing process, we'll have control over this. So it's going to be a pretty substantial night. So keep your chops, preserve your chops as well as you can. And the other thing is, it generally takes, even with all this sophistication, and I'm sure you guys have done recording sessions before and even some mixing before, but you can fix a lot of stuff. Generally, it takes 15 minutes to a half hour to fix any mistake, whether it's a rhythmic mistake or a note mistake, but with Melodyne, you can even do that, as you're probably aware. So my last comment is, don't make mistakes. And actually, keep track of what you do. If you do something that really is blatant, tell me about it at the end of the take. We can do sections again, but we can do a lot in terms of cutting and splicing as well. So, while Gordon finishes setting up, let's take a look at Sarah's tune. Sarah's going to be the first tune that we do. We're going to do this in segments. We have to do it in three segments. Randy and I'll do the opening.
Is the click going to get fixed? Because I still hear it, and it's not the tempo that we're going to do it in.
What do you need? It's not there?
I need this to not be on right now.
The click?
Yeah.
I think you'll say that you can control that from right there.
Is that going to be the tempo of the tune?
No. I think we're still on Kyle's going to do it.
I don't know. God, I hate to go in and play with something that's...
Facebook.
Oh,
we're doing a whole thing. There's some people out there watching.
Number two.
Behind guard number two.
Okay. So does that mean I'm number one?
Are we?
Does that mean I'm number one?
number one.
See, yes. And he's got a box of his own.
I could plug it.
You madness. So, Tom, can I close the drums up now?
Yes.
I just knocked out my music here.
Maybe this will help my reading.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I think I've got that should be
batteries.
The first song is always going to be a disaster because you get everything set up properly. Gordon just moved in, so we got these new microphones, which are absolutely stupendous. Picked up a Neumann M147, and that's what Gordon is on. Hold on a second.
All right, I'm gonna get out there.
It's all Randy solo space, so we're playing the ink on this, just straight down, lick or repeat for the backups as indicated. Be sure you've got the sign in mind and the rather abrupt coda to the coda. Go to that coda fermata, and again, I'll be back and forth between the keyboard and doing a little bit of conducting, so be sure you can see me. Any conducting that I do will probably be done with my left hand. We'll stop it there. Okay, the click track will be going, so we'll stop it there completely, and then we'll take the click track out, put the next free space in for Randy, and we won't get back on the click track. We'll just take, I'll conduct us back in after Randy's second fermata. That work? Question mark?
Yeah, so we have pencil second time only at 48 for backgrounds. Is that still good?
Yeah, is that what, that's what I indicated, right?
Then pencil, right?
Yeah, so, right. So two times through the solo space, is that right? Correct me if I'm wrong. Two times through and trombone's second time backup, right?
It's not two times through. There's a first and second ending. And then it goes to 72, or 60, and then into 72.
Okay, by two times, I mean, okay, so you play 48 to the first ending.
Right.
Okay, that's right. Then you go 48 saxes, backups at 48, yeah, right, on the second time. That's right. 60, we go straight ahead. Then trombones are in it after that 8 bars, right?
Yeah. Okay. So we are playing the ink. Straight? All right. Are we ready? Are we ready, Tom? Tom, are you there? Oh, you're there. Are you there? We're rolling.
Rolling. Hold on a second.
I can't hear you. Can you hear me, Tom?
Tape is rolling. Sarah's
song.
Sarah's tune.
Sarah's tune.
Introduction. Take one. Into that click track going and then play those last two notes again, then we are at 4 bars before 14. Click track, Tom.
Thank you.
that, Tom? You know about the click track, right? It don't move. We're pushing it.
We need to turn off the pad because we don't know. Because what happens is you drop right at the bottom. This one we can't draw because it's been a test when they get things organized.
Okay, no, that's fine. There's some issues, so.
I think we've got it. I need about 3 minutes. What I have to do is I've got to rewind the tape to make sure that the click track is not bleeding through on anything on the tape.
Okay.
If you want to open that door down there, I'll play it back.
Okay. So there were some, and we're going to toss that one in. There were some mistakes on that, and we got to be careful. If you click tracks will do it to you. They'll screw you up. they'll also make you honest. So stay plugged in, and be sure you got enough volume on the click track so that that's always present, because we really pushed. Did you feel it?
Yeah.
Really pushed against that, almost enough to destroy ourselves. Perhaps we
and
did.
And then we dragged too.
That's right, we're wandering around. And,
okay, Mark, on the bass, if you could play a little bit, and I'll get that set. That's good. Thank you. Okay. I'm already in here. Hello.
Hi. Hello.
Why am I on video?
It's being broadcast to Facebook.
At the very end,
but
you can simply pause and I'll turn it up.
Just because you didn't have the camera,
that's
the only reason.
I understand the whole first section now.
Good timing.
So when you get to the one section, then when it pauses, then I'll turn it on.
The opening is without flight. Then it goes. Are you there, Tom? Can you hear me, Tom? Can you hear me now, Tom?
I don't know if I can get this going. Oh, I get it.
Thank you.
Hello, Tom.
Are you ready?
You're really ready? Everybody good? Okay, are we rolling, Tom?
Tape is rolling.
Okay, this is Sarah's tune, actually the first usable tape. It's the second tape, but it's the first usable tape. Sarah's tune.
Thank you.
Tom? Hello, Tom?
I'm sure he's doing it.
I blew it. Do it again. I missed your downbeat. One more time. What's that?
Three, four.
Yeah, I think I can this time, yeah. Thank you. came back in after looking. I can put that in there. I can fix that. Anything else that insurmountable?
Well, I jumped on that bop bop. Nobody else is playing there or anything.
On the last four?
No, it's like major, 34.
34.
Yeah, I played an eighth note coming into 36.
Oh, too. At 34, I came in instead at 32. So, but nobody's playing. I mean, can they just punch that out since none of the horns had me on their mics on?
I'd love to do it again.
So you were in a hole. You were
I was in a hole.
Okay, we can probably take that out.
What's this?
We got a note in a hole. we can take it out.
Yeah, it was two.
We can take that out. Anything else?
I wouldn't mind playing the beginning of that one more time.
The beginning of the whole film?
Yeah,
the introduction?
Yeah. And, I was measure 91. I'm not sure that came across right for the internet. Da 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 da.
Oh, yeah.
So the ensemble was not clean?
Well, I think I may have been just me. I don't know. I felt like I was floating for a minute.
If I'm remembering this correctly, it felt like, again, where it got big, we pushed a little bit on time, and then it started floating a little bit until it got centered again. That's how time felt to me there. Mm-hmm. Do the whole thing one more time?
Yeah.
It should really be good this time.
Charm.
And I'll catch the E flat major 7 voicing instead of what it's.
And I'll get the click track in right when it's paused.
Okay. I'll still go ahead and give you the vocal at the right time. You okay with that, Randy? We'll do the whole thing one more time.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can the piano go a little bit more for me? Down a little bit more.
Piano down a little bit
just
more.
For me.
Is that gonna take it down in my ears too?
Yeah.
Oh no.
That's all right. Try it. I'm okay. Let's see.
So you hear me go on that one right there? You hear a lot of
this. I wouldn't mind a little less piano, yeah. More or less.
Everything else is pretty good.
Yeah, that's cool. That's cool. That's cool.
Mark, is it okay now? Okay now?
I think so. You play again?
Dr. Becky?
I'm good.
Making that last cue into the four measures at the end.
Say that again, David.
Do you mind getting a little bit stronger cue for those last four measures at the very end?
And actually, did I time it right with you that time, Randy?
I thought so.
I think you did.
Okay. Okay. I'll just commit. I'll commit to it, and hopefully it'll make sense. Yeah. I'll give you a little bigger cue.
Yeah.
And I'll give you a bigger cue, and I'll make the change.
Okay. You ready?
We're doing the end without the click. That last part.
Yeah. Last part. We're just. Trust our bodies to go ahead with this.
Just start from the beginning.
From the beginning once again. So no click. Okay. Whenever, are you there, Tom?
Everybody ready?
Are we there? I think so.
Tape is rolling.
upbeat after the fermato.
Should I open the door for her?
Yeah, just give her some air. Hey! Can you breathe in here?
Yeah, it's not bad at all.
Oh, good. So, what are we doing next?
Mark, are we okay now?
I'm just paying $1 million for the session.
It's just a little muddy in here, and I know that.
Yeah.
It is what it is.
It is what it is. I could turn up the treble a little bit on your outside.
I don't think so.
So, Bob, I was thinking. We can do what we just did on that fermata stuff. Click track out. Do you want to take a retard going into?
Oh, there were those two retards. I wasn't even clear about. There's three of them actually, right? Talking about 39.
39 are the fermatas. Do you want a retard going into that? It probably makes sense to do it. I think.
Okay.
I think we're better maybe just taking that from the click track, but start ignoring it when everybody goes away, which is three bars before, on your...
You have a pencil?
Yeah.
I have one, but it's not with me. Okay.
On your quarter note tied to an eighth note there, the end of that phrase, starting on the B natural half note, just ignore the click track at that point, go to the fermata, and we'll stop.
Three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, right there.
Right.
Two bars before the fermata start to retard.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, because there's nothing else going on there, and I'll join you. Just play on that last, your last D. And then I think we probably stop, unless we want to try to fight with the metronome, the click track going on through that, and find it again after your next two fermatas.
What were you thinking with those fermatas? Were you thinking just
reflective, some length, medium to a little longer than
not in time. Yeah.
No, not in time. But what I had thought is something like three clicks on each one would then get us rhythmically into that next section if it doesn't feel too mechanical.
Okay, let's try that.
You want to try that?
Yeah. So keep the clip going for the hall.
Yeah. So horns, did Joel get that before 4:43 at the end of the tenor solo? Well, it doesn't really matter. The rhythm section's got to get it. So rhythm section, Mark and Teresa, four bars before 4:43. We're just going to leave the click running on the
opening. What speed?
This one is 96. Okay. 96. And again, when he gets to he's got two half notes into that double bar. He's going to do like three counts each on that, and I'll give the downbeat on this seventh count, as it were, to start us back in time.
Okay.
We'll see if that works.
Okay.
Shall we? And then, were there some other ones?
I was thinking for those, the first one of the retard would be regular two beats, and then three beats on the next one, four beats on the next one, and then like seven beats or something on the long one, and then three and four on the other two.
Oh, three, two, three, one,
two, three, four, boom.
Sure,
yeah.
Okay. So it's three plus four on the fermatas. Going into whatever that is.
Whatever.
49. 43.
39.
Yeah, 39. So 3 plus 4, right, Bob?
Right.
Okay.
That's all in that last fermata. I mean, 3 plus 4.
Yeah. Yeah.
Don't hold me to it.
Okay. Well,
I'll try to do that.
I mean, worst case scenario, we can just back it up and try it again. Yeah. Okay. So, anything else? So, the solo space, this is ink. This is ink straight down. Solo space is just Bob. All the backups are in place. Everything's good. I will be able to conduct, and I think what we're going to probably have to do on that ending trombone is just ignore the click that's still going on. Actually, switch over to a slight retard, Teresa, in that next to the last bar, and then I'll conduct the last from whole note fermata.
Yeah, I think you can
do that. Okay.
Which way you going?
That should be okay.
Again?
I use it on 143. So I think we're ready to go whenever you're ready.
Rock and roll.
And you've got us on 96.
Yep, it's set at 96. Is everybody ready in there? We're going to go ahead. We have enough for two takes. Okay, tape is rolling. Closer to him.
happens.
Stop. Okay. Do you want to slow it down?
We could just take it from out. It was okay. Take it from the hold right there, the pause, the rest.
That'd be good.
I'll keep this one so far.
Okay. Let's do that. I was not massively aware until we right when we stopped.
So
then
pretty exciting.
We'll start the 7 clicks before 39. Okay. You rolling, Tom?
No, I will. Okay. You ready?
Yeah, let's know when you're rolling.
Okay. Tape is rolling.
Keep that in case we need to paste anything from that, but I think we're going to have to do that again. Say that again, Mark.
I think at 133 we all, the shout chorus?
Yeah.
I think we all just played over the sound of the click.
Yeah. Were you all aware of what happened there? How far ahead of time we got at 43? It's getting used to playing with the click track and being aware of the click track, maybe putting a little bit more of the track of the click in your headphone. To be sure it's there, and then because it's, as we also found out that time, it's hard to pull back with the click in place once we're ahead of it. Yeah. It can tolerate a little bit of fluctuation, but not that much.
Yeah, I'm really trying to slow down the 16th notes.
Yeah.
Can we try
133?
133?
Sure.
Just to try to hear if we can all hear the click track as we play.
Yeah, but without recording, is that what you think? Because I'm thinking we need to do the whole thing again. Bob, you okay with that?
Yeah.
Let's just run it again.
The whole thing then?
Same thing, yeah.
Okay, can you make a nasty note to yourself at 143 and again at 133 and then again at 143? And I'll do a better job. I'm going to pull a little bit more space. On that fermata before. This is why I don't like playing and conducting, but I'll put a little more space before that last fermata.
Ooh.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Anything from the drum room, Teresa? So, it felt slow to me at the beginning. And then by the time we were done with it, still in the same click, presuming, it felt okay. So I think the tempo's okay. And are we sure we're at 96 on the quarter note?
It'll be at least 5 minutes. I've got to...
5 minutes to get that on?
Yeah.
Okay.
Start again.
Okay.
It just, pick change does that.
Okay. So you got five. Anything we can do with that time?
We've got cookies. I don't know if that mixes well.
Yeah, so take five.
Yeah. There's treats upstairs.
Everybody
wants to the bathroom. Oh, right up the stairs to the left. Yeah. go on, go on. How do you think it's going?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
How do I think it's going?
Yeah.
When we all play louder, we play louder than the sound of the click. Something has to be done.
You can hear the click track going
inside while we play.
Okay.
But as Randy goes really loud,
yeah,
he can't possibly hear the click now.
Uh-huh.
Because he's right next to this, you know what I mean?
Right.
He's doing everything right.
Yeah.
But somehow, how are you supposed to hear the click still when you're just suddenly making this big noise with your instrument? It's a skill.
It's like getting the mix of the PA right.
It's almost like, I would say at certain points, you can't hear the click, and you have to just hope that you're not rushing, and then every once in a while the cloud clears, and oh yes, there I am. Or not. <Yeah. laughs> The not part is what we try to avoid. But I think that's what's going on right now. And it's sort of an impossible thing.
Yeah.
Unless the engineer actually raises the click as the music gets louder.
Mm-hmm.
That could happen, but that's awfully... That seems awfully rude, right?
I don't know.
It's not the prettiest sound.
Pushing it up higher.
The click sound. Sort of like, you know, torture. But anyway. Thanks for the cookies.
Yes, well, yeah.
I'm going to guess it's this.
Oh my goodness, Tazzy. Are you enjoying having a jazz fest?
Oh yeah, I think yes.
Oh, Tazzy. Little guy. We didn't hear you barking at all. Okay, let's go back downstairs.
I've had him on my bed with me most of the time.
Oh yeah.
But I got his new bed
here. Dad's doing a tape change, so.
Oh, okay, so yeah. A minute or two off.
But... Yeah, good. Well, I'll go see if anybody...
Yeah,
There are a bunch of drums in the way of the fridge. Maybe I'll move that and maybe they can get into the water or something or...
Oh, side.
Okay. I'll find it.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we're all getting used to the click track here, too.
Did everybody find water? It's right outside the door, I think, is what they're saying. I see no water. Oh, there it is.
It's all 10. It's all 10. Yeah. That's the good news.
Oh, cool.
Not a big haul on that one, but yeah.
Well, we're on the way. What you do is now basically just
where the hits are. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Seems to do really well with this test.
Uh-huh.
Just there the lesson is.
Ignore this.
Hello world.
Good talk.
Who came out with the first double valve?
Yeah, they were. Yeah.
That's
our second tune.
What's your professional?
Yeah. Oh no. You got it? Yeah. Okay, here we go.
I was going to do my show and then I was going to
do
it.
Oh, wait.
Oh,
my God. Yeah, right.
Oh, yeah.
Charge through that for months again, see if we can make it without a stop.
Okay.
If we have to stop, we will.
You can't do that, you're not strong.
Occlusion. Everybody good?
Randy's.
Oh, Randy's not good.
West Town. They do. They do like the musicians are plugs where it's like they wire in.
Oh, sure.
I got a brand that's like what I work with. Power.
There are people all over the country watching you.
Well,
it's true.
Did I put my cookie in there?
Sorry,
that'd be
my
car. Well, I don't have my cookie.
Inside the real take two. One, two, three.
Mm-hmm.
How did that closing feel? It's hard for me to keep away from the click track. Did it feel too rushed? Well, did it feel okay, Bob?
Yeah.
Okay. And trombones, did it feel okay to you?
Some weird cutoffs happened.
How's it going?
Good. Back in at me. What is? We're doing
it. We're doing it.
I'm gonna go back through.
Pick up 21. Just cuff the note. Pants. That was pretty bad.
21.
Pick up to 21. Beat 4. Before 21.
Oh, 21. Okay.
So, and where, okay, let's see if we can maybe tie this together. So if we did that, then what was your concern, Matt?
Oh, I just thought that 125, I mean, 133 especially.
Yeah, it's really fighting.
133 and 1.
Yeah, 125 was good. It was more like 133 up to 143.
How much space would you like to redo, Randy, going into whatever it was? 29?
Just like maybe 4 bars before that.
Okay, the problem in question was where? The bar before?
The bar before 21 on beat 4.
Okay.
Just the A just does not speak very well sometimes. And
okay. Can we do that? Can we start? Easier to start at 13?
Yeah.
Is that okay?
Yeah, that's okay.
Let's start at 13. We're going to do a couple of little segments here before we get off this, Tom.
Okay.
Let's go at 13 and into 21. Once we're at 21, we'll do the bar or two, and then that's good.
Yeah.
Can you record it?
Yeah.
Okay.
So we're at 13 now. 13. We're going about here. It's a 13 for a punch in, 13 going into 21 on the love inside. 1, 2, 3, 4. Going into 143.
Yeah, a little bit.
So if we take it 133 into 143, does that work? Okay.
Yeah.
So everyone ready? Right on 133 now.
You said 125.
Oh, I said 125. Yeah, 125 is better. 125. Are we rolling?
No, hold on.
No. Rolling. Rolling. This is 125 for a punch in, 125 to 143. 1, 2, 3, 4.
wasn't very good.
Well, we're still
143 wasn't very good.
We're still pushing, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So can we do
one more time?
One more time. 125 top. Are we still rolling, Tom?
Tape is stopped.
Tape is rolling.
Tape is rolling. This is 125 for the second time for a punch into 143. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Next song.
Next tune is Giovanni?
Great.
If you got 12 bars, I'm going to switch. I'm going to turn the page.
Tom, set the metronome.
12 bars, but you don't have them. No, you don't have bars. Never mind.
With you, buddy. Okay, that's take one. I gotta get the speed, and we're gonna go. Just don't get it.
Baseline through that solo. That's all that's happening. So he's going to play just positively attached to the click track.
Yeah, let me
and we're
going to
count
track.
Bars.
Okay. Get organized.
Okay. Then when we get to, we'll record the first half. When we get to the key change at 185, we'll go into the key change, take it into the key change on the first section, and then we'll stop and regroup and start it again. At 185, or perhaps going probably two bars before 185, going into it, and finishing the second half. And if all goes well, we'll take that here to the end. Does that work? Does that help on the
field? Yeah, that helps a lot.
Okay. Any other concerns or issues? Let's see. Bob, so.
Ouch! Ouch!
Okay. Here goes. That's a low ceiling.
We're gonna be able to do it. I'd actually love to have this on acoustic. Yeah.
Oh, I got
it
on eBay. This chair.
Get out of your way here.
They're my headphones. I got it.
It should click. There you go.
Let me turn on some power and give you some power, and then we got it.
Get yourself tuned there, buddy.
You're all clear out of your way. Tom Hartkop Facebook, and it's a live stream from there.
We're on it. But where's the link?
It's the top thing on his wall. You click on it. It has about a 10-second delay. Yeah, check it out. It'll be recorded there too.
Teresa, do I have you not in
until 185 after the guitar solo?
Are you in?
You've been running straight all the way through? How's the battery?
I can't tell. When it's totally charged, it'll be fine.
Good.
Yeah.
Oh.
How are we doing? Are we all right? Yep. Here we go.
After this, we have some food.
Yay.
Upstairs. Cookies. Wow. Treats. No beer.
No brass players.
Afterwards.
Martin, between 103 and 159, that's just where there's no piano there, right? Are you going to play
the
piano?
Right.
Okay, so you're coming in at 159.
I come in at 139.
139?
Yeah. Tom, is that click on? Okay, is that click at 108 now?
Is that click at 108?
Yes.
Clicks at 108 and we're rolling?
I will roll it.
Okay. Okay, are we good? Okay, we're going over to wherever I said, and we'll take a break at that point.
Whatever. Giovanni, we're playing right now, Giovanni.
Say again?
Conversations with Giovanni is what we're playing right now.
Yeah, yes.
108 is what you're talking about?
Okay, 108 is tape rolling.
Is the
tempo.
Is the metronome setting.
Okay, all right.
Okay, this is, are we there, Tom? This is Conversations with Giovanni. Take one, beginning. One, two, one, two. Up at 72.
Can we
do the whole thing again on the top?
Yeah.
Okay, you can stand it.
Ready?
Okay, take two. We good?
You ready?
Here we go. Here we go. Good, Tom?
Tape is rolling.
Conversations with Giovanni, take two, opening section. One. Two, one, two. Thank you. far was that, Bob?
I don't know how noticeable it is, but I miscounted at 158.
And we're okay through the solo space. The phrasing, this palestrina's phrasing is just a little bit strange. You just got to count bars and be in the right place.
That's way outside, man.
Because the bars is playing wrong notes. You and I just sound like a mistake. And it's on top. Right?
That would be true.
There are no here audible errors, so I think I stayed with it.
Yeah.
I just played different things.
Yeah. I wouldn't mind having one more take of that. On that opening.
Yep.
Is that too much of a buster?
No, not yet.
That's okay. And we were okay. Where you started that time was fine. Okay. And I'll cue the spot during the solo. That's great.
What?
If we'll share your one.
Yeah, can you do that?
Yeah, I think we can probably clean that just a bit. Bones, so one more time on
that
side.
Where did they come in exactly?
Starting where?
I don't know. It sounded like they didn't come in.
Yeah,
one.
Yeah.
149. When did Bones put me right on 49?
I'll take a look at it if you need to.
Down here at 148.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Are we good? Are we rolling? Take three now. Top. So the same place once again. We still push a little bit going into where we stopped.
Tape is rolling.
We good? One, two, one, two.
This is our click track right here.
Oh, yeah.
It's at 108. And these are all the inputs. Again, bass, drums, right through here. We have three or four tracks left over for future stuff, for guitar tracks. Then the next five are saxophones, four trombones, four trumpets, and a click track.
Nice.
one, 9 and 10.
Oh, piano's 9 and 10, yeah.
These are the new Raven monitors that came out, so they're all touch screen monitors. So in place of having more analog boards, some people bought these things. And so you can actually do all the editing and everything you want to in this. So what I do is I'm recording everything analog on the tape, and then I take all the 24 tracks once we've done all the overdubbing, and then we transfer that into the computer, and we'll do all the mixing on this. And then from here, we also have the ability to use melody. Oh, 1 second.
So let's go. Where are you in?
No,
is it 123?
Yeah, I can see.
Yeah, let's go 123.
123? Good? Are you ready? Hold on. Tape is rolling.
Give me a chord to any high notes, D flat major.
D flat major?
D flat major. Oh, perfect, okay. Let's begin.
123?
Yes.
Still rolling, Tom?
Yeah.
Still rolling.
1, 2, 1, 23.
Sometimes, and then my count is all funny. Can I take it again? 123?
123. The real take.
I'm not going to improvise anymore.
2, 1, 2, go, pass.
I'm sorry. I need help here. 23. It's 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, 1.
Do you
listen to this tape? Say that again.
Three.
Okay, let me know when you're ready, Tom.
Yeah, because we have about 2 minutes of wasted tape here.
Okay.
That we can just go over.
We'll need a little more. Yeah, go ahead and erase it. Yeah.
Can you just play it with me at 123? Just right now so I can.
I have nothing.
Do you have chords?
Okay.
No.
Shut her in again.
If you're just joining us, we are almost done with the first half of the recording session of Timberline Express Jazz Ensemble.
Let's go one more shot.
Directed by Dr. Okay. Mark.
123, one more. Oh,
yeah. Yes, rewind the tape.
Help you flatten the door for
it. Okay, I'm getting recorded.
123. We're not on?
One, he's still raising the tape.
Can I moan and talk?
That would be cool.
Can I count out loud?
Okay, keep it rolling.
One, two, three.
This is Conversations with Giovanni, rehearsal number 123. 1, 2, 1, 2. For real, yeah.
Okay.
Woo! Okay. I'm not a real cookie break. Yeah. But we're looking now 85 to the end. 185 to the end. 185 to the end. Right. Chris is reset at 163. 163, beat two.
I thought I was counting it right, but it didn't want.
I'm sorry, I said 363. Oh, 363, yeah. Just it's the part coming up that we've talked about before. I've thought about that spot. I mean it's scored fairly thin with that idea, so go lean on that a little bit, on that line just a little bit.
Right.
Let's take two before 185. Two before 185.
I was told we were going to be singing. Is it to record or to rehearse?
No, let's go for it. Are we rolling? Okay, we ready? Two before 185. Is that an okay place for Wentz to start?
Dave is rolling.
Four is better.
Converse.
Four is better.
Four is better, okay? Four bars before 185. Four before. This is Conversations with Giovanni. Second half, beginning four bars before 185. One, two, one, two.
Okay, I'll play it as straight as I can.
Yeah.
Yeah,
because since we're playing it together, you know.
Right.
Okay. You're hooked up in strange, some kind of strange, sometimes kind of strange ways. So play it accurately. Wait, roll it now. Four bars before 185.
No. Some air. Oh.
No. So that's a really bad place for me to stop.
Hold up.
To stop or start?
To start. Because
hold up.
You guys are in such a feeling of two there, and I'm all one, two, three, one, two, three, and I have a hard time getting going there. I need to like.
I'm with you on that.
I need to get. See, but I'm not.
How about if we back up to 171? Come from there.
I think that'd be better.
171. We'll start at 171, go into 180.
Here we go.
You want to go three bars before?
Yeah, I got it.
Four before, because we got an ascending line right there.
158.
Okay.
158. Okay. Yeah. Does that work for everybody?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Sorry. Teresa?
Just like,
Teresa?
Right.
We'll start at 158. And get into it. Okay? Okay? 158.
Hold on. Tapes rolling starting 158.
158, Giovanni. Into the second half and going ahead this time. One, two, one, two. Thank you.
All right.
So 158, okay. Full band, 158 going into 185.
We're going to start at 158 again. I'll go back and rewind it.
You want to rewind it?
Just to save that extra tape.
Okay.
We're like 25 minutes right now, and then one reel.
Okay.
Reel.
So am I waiting for you now?
2 seconds.
Okay.
Tape is rolling.
Tape is rolling. 158. Conversation with Giovanni. 1, 2, 1, 2.
This should be 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1.
Hold on a second. Let me go back.
For me, I think 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 is best for count off, yeah?
I know, but
then think of the, you know. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. That's okay. How I have to, I have to translate when you count.
Yeah.
158 again.
158, here we go. 1, 2, 1, 2.
For some reason, the time gets weird.
Okay, try it again. One more time, Mr. Monk.
158?
158. We good? One.
Hold on. Okay, roll it.
158. 1, 2. 1, 2.
4, 5, 6.
Thank you.
difficult.
It was all over.
Challenging.
So you want to take a break? You want to take a break and do it again?
Yes.
Let's take a break now. Give our brains a break.
Let me give me 2 seconds. You just came up. Good. I'll meet you guys. We're gonna go up the stairs or up there.
Well, that concludes this broadcast. We're going to go up and have some cookies, and thank you for joining us. We had a great time. Hope you did too. We're going to post it to Facebook, and you can watch it later too. So, have a great night. Good night.
Went to one.
No, I think you have to do that. I just got it. If we had not stopped, we